Welcome. I think I finished the last video. I said I was in the pet room. I'm in the TV room. And I have the VicSwitch connected to 864's and 4/15/41's. But it's been having some issue too. Yeah, they're not all happening. And I might have duped something. So what I'm going to do... go back over here. And I'm going to, one by one, turn all... VicSwitch does get some times confused when things are not working. I'm going to load the directory from drive A. Alright, but we're still kind of stuck. Alright, I'm going to do something I don't want to do, but I'm going to do it. I'm going to unplug the VicSwitch. Wait. I can plug it back in. I think. Look, VicSwitch. Alright. I'm going to send the command again. Okay. Now we're cooking with gas. 5-3-2-8-0. And I think I'm going to extend that the time thing a bit. And then in 0, just so I can have to do this again. 5-3-2-8-0. Initialize all the drives, and then it does it again. Okay, so I'm going to say quote. I'm going to call this one X. Right. Right here. This device one. Okay. So now, I see there's keys pushed down here. So now I reload. That was not right. Clear the screen. Clear the screen. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to stop this one running. I'm going to load. Load, quote, fix, quote, update. What's going on here? I'll tie it up again. those two. Somebody is running. Here, how did that happen? That didn't help. So this power one came out. Not good. Somebody is running. I know it. I'm not sure which one. What is happening? Two is running. Things are happening. It's still going. Alright. Oh, I'm looking at the wrong one. 1, 2. No. Let's just see what we have here. 2, 3, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3. Very hard to see what's what here. I think it's all good. I just it's, I mean, something is happening. Four, five, six, seven. Okay. Well, just because it's close here. Which one? This one back here. I'm thinking more and more what we have here is operator error. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 6, 7. Now 8 doesn't seem to be. Four and five. All right. Not allowed to drop so many cables. Which is this one? Oh. that different noise, that means we should now. Okay, 3, 4, 5. Now we got 6, 7, 8, 9. 1, 2, 3, 4. Do you not have 5? Which one is number 5? This one? Here? Change. I'll very carefully take it run. Come over and look and see. 1, 2, 3, 4. There's no problem. 3, 4, 6, 7, 8. All right, just a second. Which one, again, is 5? Okay. Take a guess, but this is it. Listen. Any drive change? Should I deal with it here? 1, 2. Okay, where is 5? Where is 5? Never such. Essentially, yes, the same as all working. By the time I figure out which is far, I will have pulled out something else. Listen for any change in the drive. 3, 4, uh-huh. Okay. cable. That's in the way. What's that power? I think quantum operator. Where's something going on here? There could be something wrong. Function key is being pressed. Okay, stop. We should hear when the lab device is pressed. That's empty. Okay. Okay, so, I think it's fine. I think it's just that I don't have things connected to monitors, and in pushing on things and having them stacked up here, weird things are happening. If I see everything is doing its thing here, I see no sign of anything bad. Anytime I do find something that's gone squirrely, it's because the machine has gone squirrely because of something being pressed. All right, I'm going to ponder. I'm also going to go look for printers and see what I can do. The lights flash here ever so nicely. 8, 9, 10, 11. All right. I gotta ponder my next move. Anyway, what I think is happening is fine. Operator error, as they say. Anyway, thanks for coming. If you ever use the VicSwitch, let me know. And what you use it for. And I'd be interested to know, especially if anybody used it for bulletin boards. That would be cool. Except for downloading. Most bulletin boards, there's not a whole lot of disk access. I prefer just messages. Probably just fine. I'm just going to look over here. What do we got? 1, 7, 8. 1, 2, 4, 6, 7, 8. Isn't it great? All right, that's enough from the TV room. Bye for now.